So let's go this way onto, I don't remember the route, Route 7, 6 or 7, I think. Actually, let me check up here real quick to see if there's any hidden items. Because there are some that I don't know about. So you can fight this lady right here, or you can fight this old dude. You have to choose. I usually just fight both. It really depends on what you want to use, if you want to do the Mew glitch, or if for some reason Clefairies are like really hard to beat. Oh my gosh, this sleep is lasting forever. Seriously? Oh, there, finally. Fury attack. Yeah, I think so. Dear. Let's see how much better Fury attack is. Okay, so Fury attack did that much. Oh. And let's see how much Horn attack does. Yeah, it's basically the same, and that was with a lot of hits, I really think. It was like four or five. Okay, let's fight this guy, Gambler, Growlithe. There we go. And then Vulpix. Vulpix is also pretty good in Generation 1, but also not that good because it's just, I don't know, it's okay. Its special is pretty good, which was changed into special offense, I think. I don't know. But basically, it's better in Generation 1 than Generation 2. So a couple things now. If you cut, okay. Oh, by the way, I don't know if I mentioned this. When you're giving HMs to your Pokemon, definitely have an HM slave. Because in Generation 1, you cannot remove HMs from a Pokemon. No matter how high level they are, there's no move deleter. You can never get rid of an HM once you have it. So don't waste it on like your starter or something. Unless it's a good one. So in this grass right here, you can find Ekans. I don't remember all of them. Let's see if we can encounter them now. Mankey. Okay, fighting type. Pidgey. I know about Pidgey. Ooh, what's that? More Pidgeys. Ekans, Mankey. Pretty sure there's another type here that's rare. I might be mistaken. I know there's one right nearby, and I thought it was in here too. It might just be in like yellow or something, or in blue. Nope, here we go. Growlithe. Let's do a tackle. Let's hope it doesn't take it. Oh, man, it crit. Dang it, now I have to go for another one. Stupid thing. Okay, here we go. Poison Stinging? Please don't take it out. Please. Okay, good. Oh, good. Okay, item. Pokeball. Yes. Okay. The Growlithe, the puppy Pokemon, very protective of its territory. It will bark and bite to repel intruders from its space. No nickname. We're gonna use Growlithe on our team. It's a little low leveled. Shouldn't be too bad. Let's see, what does it know? Bite and roar. Yeah, so not a very good move set. It should learn Ember soon, I think. Let me just think of my Pokemon team real quick. Yeah, okay. I know who I'm using. Okay, let's exit that. Let's save just in case I end up doing something stupid. Okay. So, we're gonna finish this route. Whoops. Paris. Cut. So there are two people facing one way and two people facing the other way. I do believe most of them are breeders, which means that they have a lot of low-level Pokemon. Dang it, already died. Oh, let's use Fury Attack. There we go. Fury Attack. Okay, that hurt. What was I? I just had a complete, like, I don't know. My brain just, I don't even know. Okay. Let's just take out the rest of these guys and then go heal up. Okay. Bam, bam, bam. Oh my gosh. Okay. Let's go. Ooh, there's a guy there. We'll fight him later. Okay, heal. Go this way. Let's actually fight this guy. Okay, Poke Nerd. Let's try to bite. Ooh. Pokemon Switch into Nidorino. Horn Attack, there we go. Horn Attack. And Fury Attack. Pokemon Switch, Nidorino, use Horn Attack, Fury Attack. Oh crap, I didn't mean to do bite, I meant to switch out. Horn Attack. Oops, Poison Sting. Poison Sting. Horn Attack. What? Oh, they're using Growl. Fury Attack, Fury Attack. Payday, Horn Attack. I didn't use Payday, it used Payday. I was just saying that. So, Payday increases the amount of money. So see that $96. I think it's like, I don't know, some number like $16 for every time it's used or whatever, and then they use it 6 times, so it's 96. Something like that, where you use it a certain number of times. Is that all of them? No, okay. I don't know why her visible range or whatever was shorter. Horn Attack. Horn Attack, there we go. Horn Attack, Horn Attack. Okay, she just said that she doesn't like Pokemon evolving because they get uglier. That's funny. Okay, honestly, never, ever, 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 ever fight this person. Ever. No matter what, forever. Okay? You got an underground path from Celadon to Lavender Town. Why do we need that? Why can't we just go over here? Well, over here. I'm on guard duty. Gee, I'm thirsty, though. Oh, wait there, the road's closed. Ugh. He won't let us through because he's thirsty, just like the last several guards. So let's go in here. The apartment in Celadon has a great selection. Okay, let's go check for hidden items. Shouldn't take too long. Should always check the underground routes because they usually have some items down here. They might not have it in this one. Might just be in the vertical one. But maybe. Yep, okay, nugget. Nuggets are good. So that's in the second row from the top. Closer to the other end, and towards Celadon, than the end towards here. Keep checking. I'm just pressing A over A over A over whatever. Because if you hold down over, then A doesn't work. So I have to alternate. That might have been the only item, but better to be safe than sorry. We're almost done anyways. Come on, give me something good, like a nugget, again. That was probably it. Oh, no, elixir, over here, on the bottommost. Nice, that means that there might be another one up in the other thing. Because there were two down here, why wouldn't there be two up there? I heard a sleepy Pokemon appeared near Celadon City. Let's go check it out. I think we already heard of a sleepy Pokemon. Underground path. Okay. If you go over here, nothing on here. Actually, over here is... you can actually go on this route, I do think. Yeah. Okay, but up here, this grass, you can find Growlithe in this. I think it's a higher chance, because back there, I think it was 5%. This is, I think, 10%. So twice as often. But it's still a little rare. But that's okay, because there's no natures, there's no IVs, whatever. All Pokemon are identical. So let's... This is Celadon City. Let's heal up. So we're going to explore Celadon, and then we're going to end off the episode. But that's not going to be for a while. Celadon's huge. So first you'll notice there's a brick path behind these buildings. And it's like, what? Why? Well, if you go over here. Check for hidden items. Nope. Hidden item. I thought there was one over here. I don't know, whatever. But if you go this way, you keep going. Is there a hidden item over here, maybe? No, okay. But, so right here, because it's a breaks in these trees, you might not notice it, but there's actually an entrance right here. We're going to go in the front of this building a little bit. So we're going to go down here, down there, or up. I'm sorry. Up. Till we get to the roof. The blue is just the roof. I know everything. I know everything about the world of Pokemon and your Game Boy. Get together with your friends and trade Pokemon. The very first time I was in here, I thought he might have been a trainer, so I just went around him. But now I know he's not. Let's check the blackboard. Trainer tips. Using a game link cable. This is really cool. You guys want to read how to link a Game Boy? When you have your Game Boy link, whatever, with another Game Boy, talk to the attendant on the right. Any Pokemon Center. Let's talk about Coliseum. Coliseum lets you play against a friend. Trade Center. Trade Center is used for training Pokemon. Yeah, that's very helpful. I actually have a Game Boy link cable. It's so cool. It's like yellow and blue and purple, or yellow and magenta and purple. It's really cool. It's like kind of clear. It's a pamphlet on TMs. There are 50 TMs in all. There are also 5 HMs that can be used repeatedly by Silphco. Well, we heard of the Silphscope. Let's see what this item is. Maybe that's it. Eon got Eevee. What's an Eevee? Oh, it's a Pokemon. But there's no room. Eevee was sent to Box 1 on PC. You know, I wish I did that in future games. In future games, are like, oh no, you don't have space for this right now. You need to wait until, like, they get that. I don't know. It's maybe they just do that with items. I don't really know. But I do know that they've done that before. And it gets really annoying. Ugh. So that's the only hidden entrance in the back. Let's talk to some people. This is my trusted pal, Poliwrath. It evolved from a Poliwhirl when I used Waterstone. Let's talk to this person. He's a little mysterious. Keep out of Team Rocket's way. That's Team Rocket. What aren't people gonna stop him? Like, what's he doing in here? Let's go over here. Over there. Ugh. I got my coughing Cinnabar. It's nice, but it breathes poison when it's angry. Coughing's a nice Pokemon, actually. The game corner is bad for our city's image. Although coughing gets better, I think, as the game progresses. Moan, I blew it all at the slots. I knew I should have cashed in my coins for prizes. Rocket Game Corner, the playground for grown-ups. What else is this? Trainer tips. Guard spec protects Pokemon against special attacks such as fire and water. Keep your items and sell it on the department store. Coins exchange for prizes. Prize exchange. You can go over there, but there's not really a point when you can just... Well, actually, there is kind of. Okay. Let's go over here. Paris, cut. If we go up here, hit an item, you get a PP up. PP ups are kind of nice. Not that nice, because you can only, there's only a couple of them, and you really need a lot if you want them to be helpful. If you go in here, it looks like a Pokemon Center, right? Well, it's not. I'm on vacation with my brother and boyfriend. Celadon's such a pretty city. It says brought me on vacation. Why did she bring her brother? That's funny. Okay, let's talk to this guy. Pokemon? No, this is a hotel for people. We're full up. Okay, so you notice that it looks... This is a nice glitch that I love. So you notice that it looks like a Pokemon Center. Because technically, it is. They took the Pokemon Center and they doubled its width. Right? And then they got rid of some of the sprites, like Nurse Joy and the Machine and the PC. They got rid of the sprites. They didn't get rid of the actual thing. If you go over here, you can use the PC. That just blows my mind. You can walk here, too. You can walk here. You can use it. I don't think you can use it. You can't use it from the side. Can't use it from the inside. Whatever. You need to be facing right here. Right where the PC is. And you can use it. This is incredibly cool. Now, what's pretty cool, too, which also you can do with any other PC, is if you press down at just the right moment... hold on, let's see if I can get to work again. Ooh, it's a little hard to do on an emulator. It's much easier on the Game Boy. Hold up. You gotta press down it just before. Hold up. There we go. If you press the slight down, which is basically just turns your view, and you press A at the same time, you activate the computer right before you turn around, and then you turn around. So now, I am using an invisible computer backwards. It's behind me, and I was using it. You can also do that with any of the other PCs, but... I'm using a computer that is behind me, and the computer is invisible, which is incredibly cool. In fact, let me go and deposit some items, because I'm about to be full up. Let's get rid of Swift. Let's get rid of Snugget. And the PP up. And the elixir, and the max ether, and flash. I don't remember what the other TMs are for. I know that's dig, but I mean the other ones. I'll just keep them out. Okay, so let's go to leave. I think that's really cool though. So let's leave. Go over here, let's check this out. Let's talk to this person. Don't touch the poster at the game corner. There's no secret switch behind it. Chief, we just shipped 2,000 Pokemon as slot prizes. Hee hee hee, the slots just reel in the dough big time. Dang it, I was trapped. Ugh, okay, here we go. Let's get going. What are you staring at? Let's go in here. There's a secret basement under the game corner. Munch. The man at the table lost it all at the slots. Well, it wasn't that guy. Hi. We're taking a break now. Oh, well, thanks. My Pokemon are weak, so I often have to go to the drugstore. So let's talk to this guy. Go ahead, laugh. I'm flat out busted. No more slots for me. I'm going straight. Here, I won't be needing this anymore. So this is the coin case. You can put coins in here, and then you can gamble. And play poker, or play slots and stuff. It's fun. Lots of fun. And it's safe, too, because Nintendo sponsors it. Just kidding. Before we go in there, let's go back in this building that we went in the back entrance of. This is Celadon Mansion. basically, this is where all the game designers live. Clefairy, Nidoran, and Meowth. My dear Pokemon, keep me company. Meowth even brings money home. Yay. Meowth. For the money. Let's read the sign. Game Freak Meeting Room. We turn on the PC. It's just a normal PC. Those are kind of fun. If you try Bills, you can't use your PC. You just use Pokemon Collection. But so yeah, you can use yours here. That's nice. Let's just go up here more. Okay, here we go. Game Freak Development Room. I wrote the story. Isn't Erica cute? I like Misty a lot too. Oh, and Sabrina. I like her. I'm the graphic artist. I drew you. Me, I'm the programmer. Is that right? I'm the game designer. Filling up your Pokedex is tough, but don't quit. When you finish, come tell me. So, I'm gonna, between this episode and next, probably. And then here's just a roof. No hidden items, I don't think, right? Yeah, no hidden items. So between games, or between, episodes, I'm going to see if I can find out what Pokemon I need to keep for the Mew glitch so that I can get the tradable Pokemon, and then we can go here and get, and get our certificate for completing the Pokedex. Because other than that, it shouldn't be too hard, because you can get a lot of the version-exclusive Pokemon easy. Starters aren't too hard to get. You can just... Well, yeah, starters are a little bit harder to get, because you have to... You either have to trade with somebody, or you can do the Mew glitch, which is fine. I actually got all but 4 Pokemon once. I had all but Onix, Alakazam, Golem, and Machamp. Now you're wondering, how did I have Gengar and not Onix? Well, Gengar I got through a Mew glitch. Through the Mew glitch, and Onix, I just couldn't find him. I went into Mount Moon, I went into Rock Tunnel, I could not get him. It was ridiculous. I spent like hours, and he just didn't show up. It was ridiculous. So, let's read this. Celadon City, the city of Rainbow Dreams.